Buongiorno a tutti. I am Chef Rosario with the National Pasta Association. Today I'm going to share one of my favorite recipes with you involving pasta and fagioli, beans, pasta e fagioli. There are several variations on this recipe. I'm going to do a very simple, easy recipe that you're going to love. And this is my own Rosario's pasta e fagioli. These are borlotti beans, very similar to cranberry beans. Then I have pasta, and today I chose a very special pasta. Ditalini, which is a typical pasta that is used in soups. But this pasta is actually made with farro, so an ancient grain, very rich, nutty flavor pasta. E fagioli. The foundation of my soup is gonna be the soffritto, with two F's and two T's. Not the soffritto, but soffritto. So the Italian version of soffritto. Carrots, celery, onions. This particular soffritto has a little garlic. And I'm gonna have a secret ingredient here, Calabrian chili peppers. That gives you an extra punch. Then I have some Sammarzano tomatoes to go in the soup. And that's about it. I'm starting with dry beans. The reason why is that I'm gonna use the broth of the cooking broth, for my soup. So yesterday, last night, I soaked about half a pound of beans in cold water and I refrigerate them overnight. The next morning, I rinse the beans and I cook them with 6 cups of clean cold water and a couple of bay leaves. These are my beans, almost ready. And I'm gonna start my sofrito right now, which is the foundation of, I would say, almost all of the Italian soups. Let's get the pasta fagioli going. First, the soffritto. I'm gonna do 1/4 cup of extra virgin olive oil. In some old recipes, people use lard. This is quintessential Mediterranean cooking. I'm going to flavor further the soffritto with some cracked black pepper. And I put the pepper now so it kind of toasts into the mixture, right here. And I'm gonna put a little bit of Calabrian pepper. They're a little hot, but they're very flavorful. The herbs, sage is typically, this is from my garden, is typically used with beans in Tuscany and Umbria. I'm gonna hand turn some fresh sage, smell. And of course, rosemary, which in Tuscany grows everywhere. There are hedges of rosemary. And this is the soffritto. Beautiful colors, great aroma, and great sound. Listen. Yes, the soffritto is gone. Soffritto is perfect, it's ready. And now I want to put my beans in. But first, I have to remove the bay leaf. I'm gonna remove about half of the beans and put them in the soffritto. Also, I'm gonna add 14 ounces of tomatoes and I break them up just like this. At this stage, I'm gonna add 2 cups of bean broth. Okay, salt, maybe 1/2 teaspoon of salt. I'm gonna taste it. Oh, delizioso. The farro ditalini, ancient grain, into the soup. And this is gonna cook for about 10 minutes. This is a soup, so it doesn't have to be too al dente. Plus, farro is harder
than semolina.
While I wait for the pasta to cook, 10 minutes, I am going to puree these beans right here, so they give an extra creaminess to the soup, right in the pot. The beans are pureed and they made a cream, a wonderful cream. It goes into the soup. It's going to make the soup velvety and silky without adding any cream. So I'll show you the final tricks for serving it. This is a thick soup, remember? It's supposed to be like this. Here it is. I have these celery sprigs from the heart of the celery and a little pecorino. If you're vegan, the pecorino is optional, but if not, enjoy it. It will give an extra depth to the pasta, just like they do in Italy. A little sprinkle of extra virgin olive oil. Signore e signori, la pasta e fagioli, Chef Rosario, the National Pasta Association, share the pasta.